Welcome back. Now that we've seen a little about how QSIS devices are configured, let's take a step back and think about the different types of network traffic, specifically thinking about multicast traffic. Before multicast, there's unicast, where a device is sending a packet point to point to another device on the network, and there's only one destination. There's also broadcast. That's when a device is sending a packet that it wants all devices in that subnet to hear. This would have a whole subnet's worth of receiving devices. But what if we only want certain devices on a network to hear a given packet? I have more than one intended receiver, but I don't want to broadcast the packet everywhere on the subnet. That's where multicast networking comes in. This technology makes use of a virtualized IP address and MAC address range to facilitate a dynamic flow of packets to a number of destinations. The address range is specifically defined from 224.0.0.0 to 239.255.255.255. The destination MAC address of a multicast stream is calculated with a special OUI, 01-00-5E, so that switches and routers know to handle this as a special case. Switches and routers with the right functionality can be configured to make sure multicast traffic reaches only the ports that want it. This functionality is referred to as the Internet Group Management Protocol, or IGMP. If a given switch doesn't support IGMP or it isn't enabled, then multicast traffic is effectively handled as a broadcast. Multicast models are typically used for device discovery, such as QSIS device discovery, and multi-destination media streaming that requires a lot of bandwidth. If these media streams were broadcast, they would bog down the entire network. Making them multicast streams helps manage the bandwidth used and make sure they only go to the right places. The IGMP protocol allows devices to register for the multicast transmissions that they would like to receive. The mechanics of this process rely on a few different aspects of the protocol. IGMP snooping is the feature you're enabling on the switch to provide this functionality. This allows for the registration of groups with the switch. An IGMP querier is then required to maintain the list of which endpoints would like to receive which multicast streams. Note, there can only be one querier per network. It asks each device on a regular basis what multicast groups it wants to be a part of. The multicast routing function actually decides which stream should go to each port based on the switch's table of registrations. That's ultimately how the bandwidth is limited to only the necessary ports. There are three versions of the IGMP protocol. In version 1, groups can be joined, but a device can't unregister for one. In version 2, devices can join and leave groups. And version 3 allows a device to register for groups only transmitted by a specific source. Note that QSIS devices support IGMP version 2. QSIS uses a number of multicast elements to do its job. As I mentioned before, the QSIS discovery protocol relies on multicast. Instances of the designer software and QSIS cores send multicast discovery packets in search of other QSIS devices. When this discovery message is heard by a QSIS device, it sends a unicast reply back to the sender. Ever notice that you can see a device in QSIS configurator that's on the wrong IP subnet in red? This is an important observation about multicast traffic. Since it makes use of virtualized IPs and MAC addresses, it bends the rules a little. QSIS cameras use the Web Discovery Protocol for some specialized features. The Precision Time Protocol is also a multicast technology. And then finally, we have a number of multicast audio and video stream types. AES-67 audio is one example. AES-67 streams are always multicast. Note that all multicast media streams must have a distinct address, or we find ourselves in trouble. It's kind of like duplicating an IP address on the network. Of the multicast protocols listed, only the multicast media streams consume much bandwidth on the network. One question we get a lot is, when do I need to configure IGMP snooping, as it can be difficult to configure them on some infrastructures? QLAN streams are unicast, so a standalone QSIS audio system, even a very large one, often doesn't need any IGMP features enabled. Here are some guidelines that will help you decide if IGMP snooping and filtering is required on your network. Are there any 100 megabit per second devices on the network, such as TSC7s or Audinate Ultimo devices? These devices can tolerate much less broadcast traffic than a 1 gigabit per second device. Do you have multicast video on the network? IGMP is a must in this case. Do you have more than 5 multicast audio streams on the network? Remember that AES-67 makes use of multicast streams for everything. If your answers to those questions are all no, then you should be fine to leave IGMP snooping disabled on your switches. All right, let's take a break there and feel free to proceed to the final video whenever you're ready.